Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Today I'm just giving you a quick little insight as to the power of garlic. Now, in one of my recent videos last week, I looked at your fish stop eating, right? I look at the fact that your fish might stop eating for several reasons. One of which is that the fish is new to the environment, so it's like it's just scoping out to see what's happening and it's refusing meal, right? Now, garlic is a very good means of enhancing your fish, one, coloration, and two, its appetite to consume more food. It's like, you know, you take certain tablets and for illness, and these tablets will like open up your appetite to consume more food. Okay, so garlic is a very good thing to actually give to your fish. In a short bit, I'll show you what I do when I'm actually preparing my garlic for my fish. In addition to the fact that garlic acts as an appetite enhancer for your fish, garlic, right, it serves as a means by which the parasite which may exist within the water or even within the fish itself to be killed. So therefore it's like a worm medicine, right, for your fish. Your fish will love you for it. It might not smell too wonderful on your hands, but garlic really works, right? So I'm going to be pulling this package right now, and I'm going to be showing you what I do with regards to enhancing the health of my fish. Stay tuned. Okay, so some persons might have varied ways of using the garlic, right? And by the way, garlic is good for humans also because it has some means of I think it has to do with your pressure. I think you can use it to adjust your blood pressure. Alright, but for the benefit of my channel today, I believe it's fish. Alright, so what you could do, you could blend it, you could cut it up, you could grind it. It depends on how you might choose, right? For the benefit of this video, I'm just going to be doing about two or three pegs, in which I am going to be actually chopping it up in pieces, fine pieces, and then I'll be placing it in the pans. Now the fish doesn't have to eat it at the same time. They will nibble on it eventually, yes. But the fact that the water will have the garlic flavor should actually help to manage the amount of parasite that exists within the pond, right? And my hands will be smelling on garlic for the entire day. Yeah, great. All right, so cleaning up this peg. I have 17 containers and I want to drop a good amount of garlic in each. So, and you can do this like once a week, or probably depending on your fish stock, you can do it once a month, right? It's like consuming vitamins every morning before you become active throughout the day, right? And this is really cool for your fish. It helps them to look good and it caters for their health. Alright, so I'm trying to do it as fine as possible, although I know I won't be able to do it as fine enough for the fish to actually eat it at one go. But what will happen is that it will end up decaying or breaking down in the water much quicker because it is finer, right? So I am just imagine the smell of garlic on my hand, in the plate, and around my the exact area in which I'm presently working. Right, so I am cutting up the garlic with the intention of feeding my fish, or should I say, helping my fish to stay healthy. This should get rid of the worms that you might identify at the butt, you know, the white thing hanging on, the white wormy looking thing, long thing, it looks like it's pulling down the fish in the water. This can help to control that, right? And this takes a good amount of time, right? So fish keeping is not a luxury hobby. Fish keeping is a hobby that keeps you thinking, keeps you active, being creative, and managing your fish stock the most appropriate way. So follow me now as I put a little bit of garlic into each of my fish pan. So here, garlic. I don't need to put much because after a couple of hours, the entire water will smell like garlic, and it should flavor the water just like how you would flavor chicken. Right? So I am placing a little garlic in each of my pans so as to ensure that my fish remains healthy. Right? So that's it for fish keeping Jamaica. Thank you for watching. Have a wonderful day. Irie.